Hello friends, welcome to the series of lectures of immunology. This is the seventh lecture of immunology in which we will going to deal with the transplantation immunology. As in previous lectures, we have already dealt with the antigens and their type, antibodies and their types, various serological reaction, the role of MHC, that is major histocompatibility complex, and now we will be dealing with the transplantation and the various issues related with the transplantation. It will be easier for us to understand as it's a series of lecture which will be dealing with the another aspect of immunology, and this is the transplantation immunology. Transplantation refers to the implantation of tissue from one individual to another. The implanted tissue is called graft or transplant. The animal from which the graft is taken is called donor, and the animal in which the graft is placed is called recipient or host. In transplantation, cells or tissues or organs are transplanted. The structure used for the transplantation include individual cells, tissues, skin, kidney, heart, eye, etc. Transplantation immunology refers to the study of the responses of the immune system when a graft is implanted to an animal. Now, coming on to the types of the graft, the grafts are classified into the four types. They are as following. First is autograft, which is also known as autogenic graft. Second is syngraft, it is also known as syngenic graft. Third is allograft, it is also known as allogenic graft. And fourth is xenograft, that is also known as xenogenic graft. Coming on to the first type of graft, that is autograft, or also known as autogenic graft, it refers to the graft that takes place within the same individual. In autograft, the tissue of an individual is removed from one place and is implanted in another place of the same individual. Autograft is a common phenomena in plastic surgery and orthopedic surgery. The antigen present in the autograft is same as that present in the body. This is one of the example of autograft graft, in which we can say that the autograft acceptance takes place. For example, when epidermis is grafted, it takes about 3 to 7 days for revascularization, about 7 to 10 days for healing, as well as about 12 to 14 days for resolution and acceptance of graft. Coming on to the second type of graft, that is syngraft, also known as the syngenic graft. Syngraft is a graft that takes place between two genetically identical individuals of the same species. It's a graft between identical twins or between inbred strains of the same species. Formerly, syngraft was also known as isograft. In syngraft, the histocompatibility antigens are identical, and hence the graft survives and it is non-rejected. The third variety of graft is allograft, also known as allogenic graft. Allograft is a transfer of tissue between two genetically distinct members of the same species. The allograft was formerly named as homograft. In allograft, the histocompatibility antigens are dissimilar, and hence the immune response is elicited and the graft is rejected. Coming on to the xenograft, that is the fourth type of graft, also known as the xenogenic graft. Xenograft is a graft or transfer in which the transfer of tissue between two individuals takes place of two different species. Formerly, xenograft was named as heterograft. In xenograft, the histocompatibility complex antigens are so different that the graft is more vigorously rejected than in any other allograft. Coming on to the graft acceptance, we can say when transplantation is made between genetically identical individuals, the graft survives and lives as healthy as it is in the original place. When graft tissues remain alive, it is said to be accepted, and the process is called the graft acceptance. The graft is accepted because the antigens of the graft and the host are identical, and hence there is no immune response for it. Coming on to the graft rejection, when transplantation is made between genetically distinct individuals, the graft tissues die or decays. When the graft tissues die, the graft is said to be rejected, and the process is called the graft rejection. The graft is rejected because the antigens of the graft and the host are different and the immune response is elicited, leading to the death of the graft tissue. The immune reaction leading to the graft rejection may be of two types. They are host versus graft reaction and graft versus host reaction. Coming on to the first type, that is host versus graft reaction. In most transplantation experiments, the graft tissue antigens induces an immune response in the host. This type of immune response is called host versus graft reaction. In allograft rejection, we are going to study this type of pattern. Allograft is a graft transfer of tissue that takes place between the two genetically distinct members of the same species. When the transplantation is made between the two genetically distinct species or individuals, the graft dies, decays and is eliminated from the host. The death, decay and elimination of the graft tissues from the host is called the graft rejection. This is one slide where you can see both the rejection patterns, that is host versus graft as well as graft versus host. Now, the allograft rejection is of three types, namely acute rejection, hyperacute rejection and insidious rejection. Coming on to the first type of rejection, that is acute rejection, we can say that acute rejection is quick graft rejection. It is further classified into subtypes, namely early acute rejection and late acute rejections. In early acute rejections, it is due to the stimulation of the T lymphocytes and cell mediated immunity, whereas the late acute rejection is due to the stimulation of the B lymphocytes and humoral immunity. It is caused by the production of antibodies, deposition of the immune complex, participation of the complement and the aggregation of the platelets. On the second type of rejection, that is hyperacute rejection, it is a very quick rejection. It is similar to the second set rejection. It is due to the pre-existing humoral antibodies in the serum of the host as a result of presentation, pre-presentation with previous grafts, pregnancies and blood transfusion. Third type of rejection is insidious rejection. It is a secret rejection due to the disposition of immune complexes on the tissues like globular membranes that can be demonstrated in kidney by immunofluorescence. Now there are many mechanisms of allograft rejection. The mechanism of allograft rejection involves the following events. First is immunological contact. When a tissue is implanted, the graft antigen can pass into the local lymph node of the host. The graft antigen then make contact with the lymphocytes of the host. In second mechanism, the production of sensitized T cell and cytotoxic antibodies takes place. When the contact is established between the graft antigen and the host lymphocytes, sensitized T cells and cytotoxic antibodies are produced in the host. They bring about the graft rejection reaction. In the first set rejection, when the graft is made between the genetically different individuals, the graft gets blood supply from the host and it appears to be normal for the first 3 days. But on the fifth day, sensitized T cells, macrophages and few plasma cells invade, that is infiltrate the graft. Inflammation starts in the graft. There is extensive vascular damage to the graft. Thrombosis may also take place, which is the formation of clot within the blood vessels. Ischemia, that is a deficiency of blood in the part due to the constriction of the blood vessels, may take place, as well as necrosis may take place, which is the death of the part of the body due to the absence of blood supply. In the second set rejection, it can be compared to the secondary immune response to an antigen. When a graft is implanted in an animal which has already rejected a graft, the second graft is rejected and is accelerated rejected in an accelerated fashion in about 6 days. The rejection of the second graft is an accelerated pattern is called the second set rejection. In the fifth step, the cell mediated cytotoxic reaction takes place. The first set rejection of allograft is brought about mainly by the cell mediated immune response. During this response, antigen presenting cells bearing class 1 and class 2 molecules carry the antigen to the graft to both CD4 helper and CD8 cytotoxic T cells to initiate the process. Now let's talk about the graft versus host reaction. In some instances, the graft tissue elicites an immune response against the host antigen. This immune response is called graft versus host reaction. The graft versus host reaction occurs in the following occasions. The graft must remain inside the host and the host should not reject the graft. In second case, the graft should have immune competent T cells. The transplantation antigen of the host should be different from that of the graft. This is one of the example of graft versus host reaction. Now there are many clinical symptoms of graft versus host reaction. They are as following, like skin rashes, retarded growth, diarrhea, hepatomegaly, then splenomegaly, then increase in bilirubin production, bile ducts are damaged, general immunosuppression, as well as anemia. Now how to prevent the graft rejections? There are some important steps which we can go for. In the clinical field, for successful organ transplantation like that of kidney, heart, eye, etc., bone transplantation and plastic surgery, the graft should not be rejected and it should remain alive. Hence, during transplantation, there should not be any adverse immune reaction. The graft rejection is prevented by the following method. Important one is blood grouping. Antigens of ABO blood groups and RH blood groups located on RBC are involved in graft rejection phenomena. Hence, blood grouping must be carried out prior to transplantation. One can also go for cytotoxic antibody testing. The presence of cytotoxic antibodies in the serum of the host also brings about graft rejection. Hence, prior to transplantation, the serum of the host must be tested using donor cells. Suitable grafts should also be used, because there are certain grafts which are not rejected. Kidney is suitable organ for transplantation. Liver is transplanted for hepatoma. Thank you so much, and hope this lecture will be useful for you and for your knowledge as far as the transplantation immunology is concerned. Thank you.